After entirely too much testing, I can tell you straight away that OWC's USB-C dock performs better than any other USB-C dock I've ever seen. That said, if you need true throughput or have a 5K display to connect, the Thunderbolt 3 is still the way to go. Be sure you need it, don't just get it because you think it's cool. Here's what we did. All in all, we did 11 total tests, including an H.265 to ProRes transcoding task, USB to USB transfers, USB to internal SSD transfers, SD imports to Lightroom through each dock, gigabit Ethernet transfer comparisons, a headset quality test comparing each dock against the MacBook Pro's native headset jack, and one extra test to show why cheap USB 3 jump drives are the worst invention since the last thing you funded on Kickstarter. Oh, I'm not kidding. If you are buying your USB 3.0 jump drives in bulk, you shouldn't be watching this video. If you care about the difference between a USB-C throughput that actually does USB 3.1 Generation 1 versus Thunderbolt 3, don't buy this crap. But first, the results. In one breath, sure, why not? We could find no single task nor an SSD fast enough to slow down the USB-C dock as compared to its Thunderbolt 3 counterpart. Based on the specifications for USB-C, the only way that's possible is with a perfect adherence to spec. That's one of the most impressive results we've ever seen from a series of tests we conducted. Anyway, here are our recorded time comparisons, and here's a graph of the same thing. All right, later, see ya. Oh, you're still here. That's right, I promised you more. Get a USB-C dock if you have a single-port MacBook. I call them MacBook Nothings because they're not MacBook Airs and they're not MacBook Pros. They're just MacBook Nothings. Get a USB-C dock if you're buying hardware for a team who does mostly one I/O task at a time. If you'd rather spend the money on something fast, like, I don't know, super fast SSD storage. And yes, I'm partial to OWC's SSDs, but come on, they're awesome! Get a Thunderbolt 3 dock if you have a 5K display because, well, the 5K display is pretty awesome, and one of the benefits is to be able to plug in just one cord, which brings me to the second one. If you only want to plug one cord into your computer. Next, if you have a storage array that's actually faster than true USB 3.1 Generation 1. Keep in mind, most of them aren't, and it doesn't matter what they say. Next, you need the ports only found on the Thunderbolt 3 dock. If you want a list of those, you can get them at the full article at nerdslimited.com. Or, of course, you must have the fastest possible I/O solution. And then lastly, you have enough money not to care how you spend it. Oh, and I guess one more. You need to plug a daisy chain of Thunderbolt devices into a single port, well, for extra added awesome.
Extra added awesome.
Which brings me to the last part. Thunderbolt 3, what you probably didn't know. Oh, I think it's time to go to the web. It's infographic time! You've undoubtedly seen stuff like this from Apple, Intel, or someone talking about the amazing throughput of Thunderbolt 3. And yes, its 40 gigabit per second speed is very impressive. Now enter this infographic from thunderbolttechnology.net. Ooh, pretty. Let me call your attention to this part right over here. You see, the real magic of Thunderbolt 3 is that the speed is full duplex. That means it can provide 40 gigs per second two ways. Right below that, they explain the Thunderbolt 3 controller's processor includes an integrated USB 3.1 controller to coordinate four simultaneous full duplex lanes of PCI Express Generation 3 and 8 lanes of DisplayPort 1.2. That's enough power to transfer a full-length 4K movie in 30 seconds or a year of MP3s in 5 minutes. With that kind of pipeline, Thunderbolt 3 can take a GPU, which is one of the most bandwidth-intensive components of a system, and externalize it. While none of this stuff shows as a single-task workflow, it's worth noting that Thunderbolt 3 is in a class by itself. So there it is, the Nerds Limited summary of OWC's USB-C and Thunderbolt 3 docks. Special thanks to Larry O'Connor, OWC's CEO, for taking the time to discuss his excellent products at NAB 2018. Roll credits! Nerd out! No, of course I didn't drop the microphone. Anyone who's ever bought a microphone would never drop one like that.